That was beautiful. This is John's brand new baby. This was a tree about 3 months ago.
Wow.
Just brand new made, just had strings put on it.
Bill Moll in Springfield, Missouri makes my guitars, and they're seven string guitars. George Van Epps invented the seven string guitar in the late 30s. He was the genius. He wanted his guitar to have a range more like a piano, so he added a low string, a low A to the guitar. And instead of chords like, he had, and this is just sort of, and I played Hawaii the Moon because I wanted this guitar to look like the old, they had the solid body gold top Gibson guitars. That Les Paul sort of, there was like 1952, there's a gold top one that's really so cool. But I said, could you make it gold and put all that stuff on it? And then so, anyway, just for the guitar, for the two guitar guys out there, this one's for you. Now, this next portion of the program is sponsored by, actually the next portion of the program, we have been doing, for the last 6 years, what we call a vocalese number. And vocalese was... So one of the groups that popularized it in the 50s was a group called Lambert, Hendricks, and Ross. And they had a number of hits where they would take bassy songs and not just go da 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 da. They would actually write a lyric to the trumpet solo that followed and to the saxophone solos on 1 o'clock jump and things like that. The big hit was a song called Twisted that Annie Ross had. My analyst told me, boom, that I was right out of my head. Da, 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 da. Anyway, and the lyrics were always not just like, I love you, pretty baby, we're gonna love you. Like, Twisted, the lyric was about a person who went to the psychologist and realized the problem was she had two heads. These are the kinds of songs that people
They write. Were smoking a little pot.
There was a little pot, there were drugs involved.
Something.
Yes.
Not a
But it's grown up to say, we could say marijuana, because we're all grown-ups here. And nevertheless, they always found it fascinating. Anyway, so we've done it with a number of songs over the years, and this one is one of our favorites. It's James Taylor's Traffic Jam surrounding... a piece by Joe Henderson called The Kicker, which was on a Horace Silver record. So it's very jazz influenced. and Jesse wrote the lyric to it, and it goes on and on and about a very interesting subject.
Well, I used the real life experience when I was 24. I became engaged to a lovely fella who was a musician. And then I realized some 10 years later, when I was 34, that I was still engaged. To the point where I couldn't no longer breathe through my nasal passages, and my doctor would sing from Guys and Dolls, a poison can develop a cold. So I thought that perhaps it was time for me, since the years were spinning past, that I would sort of give this gentleman an ultimatum. So I said, what do you think? You know, it's been a long time. It's been a rather long engagement. Don't you think it's time to get married? And he looked at me and he said, and it was, so I wrote a song about that moment. That moment where you realize he who hesitates is lost, and it may be later than you think.
Damn this traffic jam. How I hate to be late. Hurts my motor to go so slow. Time I get home, my supper be cold. Damn this traffic jam. I heard so very many people say, don't you let the time slip away. If you got a banker bar, don't put off until tomorrow. The fix that you can do today. I waited, hesitated, just about the question, suggestion. But if you think that you found your girl, better grab her, better nab her. Cause every other day when she looked, fly away someone better than get her. I woke up when she spoke up, said to bring a ring for her finger. She said to bring an ASAP. If she's history, she's a mystery. I hop into my car and I'm on the FDR. Out of luck now, stop now. Damn this traffic, damn this traffic jam.
He was not the type of man with any sort of a real conviction.
Just the sort of lover who takes over in an instant.
But now I'm telling you, I'll stop. Damn this traffic. Damn this traffic.
Wish I could have told her that I really couldn't hold her for the fear that I would suffer
a benediction.
Please.
Someone way up there say a prayer for an old lonely sinner.
Oh, I've been there, done that, every old thing known to man, but I think I want to expand. I know when I was there that I can, but now
I'm sitting here like Sergeant Man. I mean, it's like no exit. Like that guy, you know, always waving, he's always so familiar to Samuel Beckett.
I could take a turn toward the river and turn my Toyota and possibly wreck it. And so long, my love, I'll see you. Better luck next time.
Damn this traffic. Damn this traffic jam.
The surest thing known to man, no matter how they flaunt you, they never really want you till they come back to haunt
to be late. Hurts my motor to go so slow. Time I get home, my supper be cold. Damn this traffic jam. I almost had a heart attack. Looking in my rearview mirror, saw myself the next car back.
Looking in his rearview mirror, saw himself the next car back. About to have a heart attack. About to have a heart attack. About to have a heart attack.
I've heard so very many people say, don't you let the time slip away. If you gotta make a bar, don't put off until tomorrow.
All the things that you can do today. Damn.